The speed of printers on the market have a range from 50 millimeters per second to 500 millimeters per second. FDM printers also have entered the age of high-speed development. So, which will be the leader of our age? That is the question. Many printers have appeared in 2022, but when it comes to printing speed, only two printers have survived in the market and were chosen for this comparison. They are the Flsun V400 and the Bambu Lab X1. Bambu was established in 2020 by a group of 3D printer enthusiasts with deep experience in R&D. Their X1 is advertised to have a printing size of 256 by 256 by 256 millimeters and has a printing speed of 500 millimeters per second. The Flsun is a brand focused on Delta printers and is dedicated to speed. Our latest product is the V400, which has a printing size of 300 by 410 and a printing speed of 400 millimeters per second. Today, we will analyze 400 millimeters per second and 500 millimeters per second from a professional point of view. Which one is faster? If you are choosing a printer right now or interested in printing speed, you can explore this with me. First, let's look at the melting rate of both of them. The melting rate is how fast the nozzle melts the filament once it enters the nozzle. The V400 nozzle is a three-hole structure, which can increase the area in which the filament enters through the nozzle. That allows for faster heating and greater flow. The nozzle of the X1 is a traditional single-hole structure, which is heating the filament from the outside to the inside. Now we can test the melting rate of the V400 and the X1 by extruding 100 millimeters of filament at the same extrusion speed, 680 millimeters per minute. V400 actually extrudes 97.43 millimeters, and the X1 actually extrudes is 86.96 millimeters, which clearly shows that the melting rate of the V400 is much higher, which means it allows for higher printing speeds. Secondly, let's look at their slice parameters. The X1 sets the slice parameters for different layer heights, and the print speed parameters for 0.12 millimeters, 0.2 millimeter, and 0.28 millimeter layer height are as follows. It can be seen that the 0.12 millimeter layer height is the fastest printing speed. This is due to the smaller layer height having a faster speed for a given nozzle flow rate. The print speed for 0.2 millimeter layer height is significantly slower and after all is limited by the nozzle flow. The V400 in the 0.2 millimeter layer height of the filling speed is 350 millimeters per second. It's much larger than the X1's 270 millimeters per second. So the X1's print speed will be limited by the nozzle flow. In order to ensure print quality, they have to set the maximum volume speed as 21 millimeters to the third power per second. In this flow and layer height of 0.2 millimeters, line width of 0.4 millimeters, the maximum print speed is 262.5 millimeters per second. During the actual test, when the 21 millimeters to the third power per second limit was canceled, the maximum print speed of the X1 was 350 millimeters per second, and the maximum volume speed was 28 millimeters to the third power per second. Compared to the V400, which was able to print at 450 millimeters per second, and the maximum volume speed was 36 millimeters to the third power per second. So the X1 is limited by the nozzle melting rate, which affects its printing speed. and the maximum print speed should be 350 millimeters per second. But the nozzle melt rate of the V400 is relatively higher, and its maximum print speed is up to 450 millimeters per second. Third, as we print the same model with the default parameters sliced for both of them, you can see the X1 has a higher inner and outer wall speed slicing parameter than the V400 and higher acceleration, while the V400 only has higher infill speed than the X1. The final print time is shown in the picture, and the V400 is always ahead. Due to the fact that Bambu Studio is based on a Prusa slicer adaptation, I found a super slicer that is also based on the Prusa slicer adaptation. The difference between the two slicers will be less, and thanks to a friend who shared the parameters in the group, the print time is shown in the picture. As you can see, Cura does not really take advantage of the V400, and in terms of time, the V400 is about 1.2 times faster than the Bambu in the case of a smaller slice difference. In general, there's not much difference between the quality of the models made by them and the effect presented by the level of smoothness has its own advantages and disadvantages, which can be adjusted according to your preferences. During the printing, I tested the noise level and the V400 remained at 65 to 70 decibels and the X1 hovered between 78 and 82 decibels and exhibited stronger vibrations. Finally, let's consider their overall structure. The V400 uses three-axis aluminum profiles. Through the cross-section can be seen that its structural rigidity is very strong. And using the double-axis slider in each profile will ensure longer life. The X1 in the Z-axis uses threaded screws and the three optical rods, respectively. The structural strength is relatively weaker. And over a period of time would be easy to be deformed, have wear and tear, and of course affecting the use of the printer. After a series of tests, the V400 is undoubtedly faster than the X1 in printing speed, and also confirms the conclusion given by the website All3DP. That conclusion being that 400 millimeters per second is faster than 500 millimeters per second. Flsun V400 is definitely the leader in printing speed. So let me conclude this video by saying, if you're more interested in multicolor printing, then go for the X1. If you want to experience the faster printing speed, the V400 is a unique choice. Thank you all for watching this video, and thank you for your time.